So we just saw the long skinny wire, or hopefully you just saw that one. I don't know where you're at in the videos. But here is a variation on the long skinny wire that I think will be a lot more dramatic. So let me show you. Well, first, this big square is wound with 44 turns of copper wire. Okay, now this wire is enameled, so basically painted. So here, this wire has plastic on it. This wire has paint on it, and that's what insulates it. And then right here at the ends, if you want, you can maybe see a subtle color difference. Right here, the paint looks slightly more reddish than here where it looks more orangish. If it's hard to see, you're not alone. But we scraped off some of the paint. But needless to say, when you see these coils in here, these are not making electrical contact to each other because there's the paint insulating it, just like there's the plastic. Now, up here, we've got this power supply cranked up to 15 volts, and this can produce a lot of amps. So we're going to produce a lot of current through 44 turns of this wire. So notice it comes into here, here's the input, then it's going to go around here 44 times back to this switch. So right now the switch is not engaged, so we don't have any current flowing. All right, now maybe come over this way a little bit and see the side view. Can you see the whole square?
Sort of.
So it's hard to get an infinitely long straight wire, seeing as how I guess that's impossible. But one thing you can do is get a very long straight wire, and the trick to doing that, as you can see here, is this side, and this side of the square are an insignificant portion, or contribute a negligible amount to the magnetic field from this overall apparatus. Let me say that again. Basically, we're going to create an external magnetic field, or we're going to create a magnetic field with this wire when we run current through it, I think this way. All right, and when we do that, all segments of wire are going to produce the same size magnetic field, but because this one, and this one are very far away, almost all of the contribution comes from here. So now we can treat this side of the square as an infinitely long straight wire. And notice under here, nothing up our sleeve, that's just a piece of wood. So I tried to build all the supports here out of non-magnetic stuff. Let's take a look at the compasses. You can see we've got a wide variety of compasses at varying distances from the wire. And this thing is a little bit crooked here, so we'll just have to deal with that. Right, so I may have to hold my finger there in just a second. But the idea is now I'm going to close the switch. All right, you ready, Angus?
Yeah.
And so we had 15 volts. We got 1.6 amps. Hopefully you see some of the compasses changing. Now watch. Let's do that again. Here's off right now. There's off. Here's on. I think this is a lot more dramatic than that simple case we had with only 5 amps. Now why is this so much more dramatic? Again, we have 1.6 amps times 44 turns. Whereas last time, I think we had 5 amps times one length of wire. So we have a significantly larger, at least 10 times the magnetic field here. So that's why this is more dramatic. Yeah, and we do see this curling. I'll put my finger here just in case these other ones work better. Yeah, that's kind of cool. That's it. You could think, what should happen if I flip the polarity? Let's do that too. So I guess you can get a shot here. All I'm doing is flipping the polarity. So now watch this. Think what should happen to the compasses. 1, 2, 3, go. And one thing I noticed, look again at the video and watch these two compasses, and depending on which polarity you choose. Or I'll just do it right now. That's with reverse bias or flipped polarity. And now with regular polarity. All right, let's call it good.